So now we're going to look at the second type of embryonic folding, which is the lateral folding. So right here we're looking at a cross section of the embryo to see the lateral folding. We're going to be looking at a cross section of the embryo. So in the previous video we saw how that we introduced a longitudinal section. Now we are going to introduce a transverse section, or an axial cut, or an axial section. We're going to remove the top part and look at the embryo from above. So we are looking at the cross section of the embryo. So if we look at this representation of the embryo, again, we introduced an axial cut or a transverse cut. We remove the top part and we are looking at the embryo from above. Okay. So this is our ectoderm and amniotic cavity. This is the endoderm and the yolk sac, and between them is the neural tube. Because this is a cross section, now we can see the neural tube clearly. And on each side of the neural tube is the intraembryonic mesoderm with its three parts. Okay, so this is the cross section of the embryo. So again, this is the ectoderm and the amniotic cavity, the endoderm and the yolk sac, the neural tube, and on each side of the neural tube is the intraembryonic mesoderm. And as we said before, the intraembryonic mesoderm will merge with the extraembryonic mesoderm. Okay. So as we said before, the intraembryonic mesoderm is divided into three parts: the paraxial mesoderm, the intermediate mesoderm, and the lateral plate mesoderm, with its two limbs or two parts. So this is the somatic layer and the splanchnic layer of lateral plate mesoderm. And as the somatic layers merges with the somatic and the splanchnic layers, they merge with the extraembryonic mesoderm, forming the lateral the parietal mesoderm, which surrounds the ectoderm, and they form the visceral mesoderm, which surrounds the endoderm and the yolk sac. So again, before we start folding, let's orient ourselves quickly. So since we are looking at the embryo from above, this will be our right side and this will be our left side. Okay, so this is the right and the left, and this is our dorsal side, and this is our ventral side. So the dorsal side is the side where the ectoderm is, and the ventral side is where the endoderm is. Now the embryo is going to start folding. The medial, the right and left, or the lateral parts of the embryo are going to start folding in the direction of the with the direction of the arrows. So let's see what happens when this folding takes place. Okay, so as you can see, the endoderm will fold. Of course, all these structures they fold together, but here I'm gonna fold them one by one for simplification purposes. So as you notice here, the endoderm has folded and incorporated part of the yolk sac, and along with it, the visceral mesoderm has folded in the same manner, because this layer is covering the endoderm and the yolk sac. Okay, and again, the ectoderm and the amniotic cavity are also going to fold in the same direction, along with the parietal mesoderm that surrounds it. So this is the first step, let's say, when the embryo starts its lateral folding. Okay, so basically the lateral parts of the embryo, the right and left parts, are approaching each other, as you can see, and as we will see in a moment. They start approaching each other until they make contact. So this is the lateral folding of the embryo. So now let's take a look what happens with further folding of the embryo. And as we said before, the right and left side are going to start approaching each other until they make contact. So again, let's get oriented really quickly. So as we said, we have introduced a transverse cut to the embryo, and we're looking from above. So this side is going to be the right side. This is the left side. This is here the dorsal side. And this is the ventral side. So right and left, dorsal and ventral. And as you can see here, how the neural tube actually got pushed towards the dorsal side. So this is our endoderm and yolk sac. Okay, and they are surrounded by the visceral layer of mesoderm. And here is our ectoderm, which is lined with the parietal layer of mesoderm, or the parietal mesoderm. Okay, so the endoderm is surrounded by the visceral mesoderm, and the ectoderm is lined with the parietal mesoderm. So now the right and left side are actually gonna start approaching each other until they make contact. And we're gonna see now how that will look like. So let's start with the endoderm. So the endoderm actually is gonna, when it finishes the folding, it will end up as a tube, which is our gut tube, as we will see. Okay, and the same happens with the visceral layer of mesoderm. So the right and left sides of the visceral mesoderm are going to approach each other until they make contact, and they will still be surrounding the gut tube. So this is the gut tube and the surrounding visceral mesoderm, which will be our future visceral peritoneum. And now the ectoderm and its lining parietal mesoderm are also going to approach each other from the right and left sides and make contact in the midline. So this is the ectoderm lined with the parietal mesoderm. Okay, and of course this is again our extraembryonic mesoderm, which will separate again from the intraembryonic one. So as you can see, the lateral folding, how it has formed this tube within a tube appearance of the embryo. So this is the endoderm or the gut tube surrounded with the visceral mesoderm. This is the ectoderm lined with the parietal mesoderm. And the parietal mesoderm is going to be our future parietal peritoneum. So as you can notice, there is a cavity or a space that has formed between the parietal and the visceral layers of mesoderm. Okay, and this space is actually will transform into the peritoneal cavity, which is the space between the parietal peritoneum and the visceral peritoneum.